Ow!
It's 7 o'clock on Monday, the 29th of September. The news this morning. After 18 months in office and no upturn yet in the economy, the Prime Minister, Mrs. Thatcher, says she stands by her economic policies. Iraq is poised to attack the Iranian city of Khorramshahr.
Thank you very much.
And in Poland, leaders of the new Solidarity trade union in Gdansk had a strike this week in support of their wage demands. Who's going to win, Reagan or Carter?
Well, some people are saying that Carter doesn't really deserve to.
No, they are not. They're back at 5:30.
Oh, why?
You know that.
Who wants toast?
Have we got any more milk?
Can't we go for a little bit?
Dan, I'm not arguing with you.
The answer is no.
Ah, you're at home, Mr. Little.
The table is shredded.
Yeah.
Well, don't do it like that, you stupid idiot. Put the sugar on first.
You can do it.
Give me the shreddies.
Hey, listen,
it's 8:15. Hurry up, you boys. You're going to be late.
Don't talk to me like that.
Come here, Adam. You look a mess.
Go on, Mum. Do you have to brush your hair at the table? Probably we'll have lice for dinner.
Hurry up.
Come on, Mum. It's the best.
I'm finished.
Harry.
You've been so greedy. Wait.
Hey, leave it alone. It's mine.
No, it's not. It's mine. Get off.
Leave it out.
Why can't I go to boarding school?
Where's your reading book?
Mom, have you seen my skateboard anywhere?
It's where you left it last night.
It's not there now. Dan, have you seen it anywhere?
No, I haven't.
Where's my keys? And my man's
keys. Good girl, I'll get my bag and we'll go.
I don't like boys.
Oh, come sometimes
on,
you do.
Mostly I don't.
That's called being female.
Hurry up, come on.
Okay, I'm coming.
Both ways crossing the road.
You'll have a heart attack one day, Dad.
Oh, just you wait.
Pooh, Daddy!
Oh, bloody dogs.
Come on. Don't forget Sally and Eric's tonight.
Don't know, but it's Ben's birthday.
Don't I get a kiss from anybody?
Swinno? Charity? That's sweet. And I haven't seen that for years. Chivalry is not dead.
Thank you, Ivan. Good manners are never out of date.
Did you see Barnes today on the biological basis of modern marriage?
It takes courage to realise we're more than biology and genetics, Steve. It's much more comforting to think of us as dumb animals. In some cases, it's more true than others. Try Brown and Harris.
No. You're married. You've got kids. Some of it must have been biological. Read Barnes.
I've got better things to do.
Then alter recurrent practices. After all, you're liberated. Get the old man to do the washing up.
Ha! Good morning.
Morning.
Hello,
is there a break?
Yes, sure.
Charity, 12:30 common room, don't forget.
Fine.
What?
Professor Carlton. He arrives today, didn't you remember? There are some very interesting rumours about him. Sociology?
No, English.
Is it? Carlton, old man.
Huh?
Swinho. Crime and Deviance. We met before, remember?
Oh, yeah. How are you?
Fine.
Very good. Oh, sorry about this. This is a bit of a disaster.
It's all right.
Professor Carlton, we're so glad you're here. I'm Mavis MacDonald, your secretary.
Ah, good morning.
Morning. Would you like to come this way?
Certainly. Yeah, just the one with us. That's it. Are you safe with that?
Yes.
Johnny, if you could do that.
I'm sure.
Thank you.
There.
Good morning, Mr. Walton.
Morning, Shelley. Busy day today. Coffee, no biscuits. Had a lapse this morning. Fry up.
I think you look fantastic. Really.
Lunch.
I'm trying.
Yes, can do.
Do you remember all those new chairs we had in the 60s? Never again. Education's been turned into a bloody supermarket.
Content, not original thought. No art in that.
Art? I thought it was a science. Nobody cares about the computers, nobody. It's like they think they don't have feelings.
Quite.
What?
And who's going to pay for the computers?
They'll never muck about with education, mate.
We haven't got all day.
Ah, Alan Pascoe, Professor, welcome aboard.
Thank you.
As head of department and most senior resident, let me introduce you around.
Certainly.
Ah, our local mechanic.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Pascoe's little joke, Professor. Mac McKinnon, computer programmer.
Good to meet you. Mm.
This is...
Steve Kirkwood, Professor. Humble lecturer. We actually met when you came before. I wonder if you could put your eye over my research when you're settled in.
Certainly, yes. Sure, absolutely.
This, Dr. Swinho.
I am.
Our crime and deviance chappie.
Yes, we met.
Ah, and this is
Margaret Lacey, Professor of Social Theory. I hope you'll be happy here.
Well, thank you very much. I'm sure I will be.
Dr. Lacey's our most recent and, may I say, very capable acquisition from Cambridge.
Oh, yeah.
Professor.
Oh, thank you. Mavis.
And Charity Walton, our research officer, engaged on her doctoral thesis, promises to be interesting. She needs an internal examiner. Maybe you'd be willing.
Certainly, yes, absolutely. We'll talk about that.
Great.
Thank you.
Well, it's great to be back. I mean, Texas has a great deal going for it, as you probably know, but the lack of good old British intellectual tradition really got me where it hurts, in the head.
Yes. They say American universities are high schools, really. No challenge there at all.
What jingoistic bullshit. Some of the most exciting and original social theory comes from the States. And let's face it, some of the best people are men.
Yes. Welcome aboard, Professor. May your stay be a happy one.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
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 We've all read your book.
Oh, dear, have you?
Your analysis of the essentially male character of revolutionary movement seemed right on target.
Oh, thank you very much.
But the journal review, that was very unfair.
Yes, you read that, didn't you? Mm.
I mean, it's not good enough to criticise someone for not being sociological enough. Look at Comte, look at Durkheim, Wright Mills. Would they have passed the test?
Well, absolutely. Well, that's a very interesting thought. That's a very interesting thought.
Excuse me, Professor. I wonder if I could have a chat.
Excuse me. Yeah,
read Barnes. I was just wondering, maybe I could drop the synopsis.
I've put it all out for you and Beth's cooking it.
Oh no, I don't like her cooking.
Yes, you do.
It's all burnt. Anyway, what time are you coming home?
About 11, and you'll be asleep.
No, I won't. Tom, where are you? I'm in the
Is James here?
No.
Oh, no, he's bringing the wine.
Oh, don't worry, neither is John and Nick. Come have a drink.
Eric's on his way.
Great.
Oh, Sally, God, your kitchen floor, you could eat off it. Mine's not fit to walk on.
Hey, these are beautiful. Can't see the join.
From the cookery book series we did.
I thought you hated all that.
I did, first. You know, lots more important things to publish. But we aren't a charity and it's made a whopping profit.
Aha!
Thanks.
And I wouldn't confess it to anyone else, but it was fun.
Your secret's safe with me. We'll have you hoovering next.
Very funny. I suppose you mean you're doing the real thing. That's why you look so chipper on it.
Oh, come on. Look, I'm the mug. Superwoman is an ugly myth. I could handle work or the children, but not both. I'm knackered.
And what about James? Charity?
There's no time for anything.
He's a perfectly nice man, but as I've always said, my dear, you married too young.
I do love him.
Ha 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 ha.
Well, that was lovely, darling. Thank you very much.
Yes, wonderful.
Have a smashing, Sally.
No, it's all right, darling. I'll get it.
Let me give you this.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you, James.
Thank you.
Right, is there some more wine?
No, not for me. I'll have a cigarette.
I'd love some. Do you cook, John?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
Don't be modest, John.
Where did you find those two?
Now, I have to travel with the times.
Why?
Voila.
John?
That's lovely, thanks.
So, Sally, how's the world of publishing going?
Doing very nicely, thank you.
Still fertilizing our imaginations while expanding in profit margins.
Poor economists. As if the meaning of life existed in numbers.
Thanks. You mean it doesn't?
Look, it's my duty to search out good authors, nourish them, allow them to express themselves.
But being an artist isn't a profession. It's a calling. God! The priest took money for taking confessions you'd want to cut.
The mullet was fabulous, Sally. How did you make the sauce?
I'll just find my cigarettes, excuse me.
It's our standard argument.
I'm so sorry.
He's pissed.
He's a pain.
And what's it all about?
I don't know. Male menopause or something.
A bit early.
Oh. I'm gonna give up soon.
What? I'm smoking.
I want to have a baby.
That's ridiculous. How are you gonna fit it in?
Take them with you to the office, you know. And having a nanny's no solution. You'll just end up running your life round her.
I don't want to die not knowing what it was like.
I want to go to mother care and buy lots of little pastel clothes.
Oh, I haven't wanted anything so much since I was 16 and dreamt about my first lover.
Yeah, well, it's nothing like that.
What's wrong?
I don't know. But babies isn't the answer.
Darling, let's go.
He's not happy. I'm sure he is menopausal. He's reached that stage men get to and they either go off it altogether or start screwing around.
Is he?
What?
Screwing around?
Nah. His libido's as flat as a pancake. Anyway, what's Eric think about all this babies and stuff?
He's thrilled. Having my coil out tomorrow, so maybe next time I see you.
It's 11:30. Bethel won't go home.
Thanks.
Sally, the food is delicious. I'm sorry I was a pig.
Don't worry about it.
Bad day, I guess.
Bye.
Thanks so much.
Pleasure.
I'm sorry.
Bye, Nick and John. Bye. Nice to meet you.
Look at me like that. I've been driving for 20 years. I haven't had an accident yet.
Oi! What do you want with your bloody guy?
Why did you talk to Sally like that?
Like what? Can't say what I think to your friends. They're too fine for my conversation. Probably late tomorrow evening. Some clients from Japan. Be home about 8 if I don't have to take them out for dinner.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I mean, I don't know why I'm sorry, but I'm fed up with this atmosphere all the time. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
Of course there's something wrong.
Really, I'm just tired. I'll have a lie-in on Saturday.
I do love you, you know.
Government, of course, denies that.
Well, they would, wouldn't they?
They say it's to do with the breakdown of family life, the increase in divorce, juvenile crime, and so forth.
Yeah, all that's been going on for years. We haven't seen any riots till now, have we? Look, man, when people have got no jobs, no money, no hope, you can't blame them for fighting back.
Just lock the door.
Yesterday to the Conservative Party conference here in Brighton, Mrs. Thatcher declared that no matter how unpopular her policies, even in the face of a Labour victory at the next election, nothing would deter...
You'll make someone a wonderful wife. What's wrong with you?
Who'd married her?
Chair.
Yep.
Here you go, darling.
Thank you.
What about dinner? Meat or fish?
Meat or fish. I know. We haven't had mussels for a while.
Yuck!
Now hurry up. Daddy can drop you off.
Have you got plans for the day?
Oh, yes. I want to get all this lot unpacked by the weekend.
Unpacking? You should see my office. You can't see my office. I tell you can't see the floor for the boxes.
I could come in. Do it for you.
No, darling, you do enough. Come on. You do too much.
We don't know what we'd do without you. We can't guess. Go on, get out of here.
The lot of
you. You'll be late for school.
Come on, bye, Mummy. I'll see you later. All right. Take it in.
Bye. Have a good day.
Come on. Get in the car.
No.
Dad, let me in, Dad.
All right.
I know it's all right.
In you jump. Oh. You all right? Good girl. There you go. Now, where would you like to go? We could go anywhere. We could go to the cinema. We could go skating. No, we know. We go to school. Sociology is about hierarchy.
Thing.
No, but you're thinking about it.
I'm 2 days late.
That doesn't mean anything.
No, I'm finding out. So, who is he? Married, of course.
No, that's good, because you both know why you're there.
Look, Charity, I know my history's not very good,
but you have to realise that variety isn't an answer to anything. Except maybe for super cops when they don't believe they're alive unless they're getting it up every day with a new woman. Can be fun. Usually it only makes things worse.
For me, there's only ever been James. First and only. I'd be too embarrassed to do anything.
You'll get over it.
It's not as though I'm looking for a relationship or anything serious. It's just I'd like for once to be wanted by somebody male and grown up.
How's your brother, sir?
All right? Thank you.
Thank you.
At least James comes home every night. Pays the bills, loves the children.
You don't even like him.
I do. Just don't think he's your type. Anyway, you have to realise that screwing around is different for women. It's got something to do with the whole business of being entered. One thing to burgle a flat, another to have to live in it afterwards. Or in the case of your husband, drop in for the occasional visit.
Our parents used to manage.
Mm.
How long have you been married? 3 years?
2.
And do you love him?
Not any hassles. He loves me. I think.
See, that's what I thought about James. I'm getting old and I don't want this to have been it.
Maybe you need a holiday.
Come back to the same old routine and find that's all that's keeping us together. And then know for certain that I'm the one doing the staying together all by myself.
You're looking nice these days.
Thank you.
See what's going on, will you?
Yeah, they'll be all right. Good for them to sort it out in their own.
Give it to me, you smelly pig!
Hey, what's going on here? Rachel, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Ow!
Tom! Come here, Tom! Who the hell do you think you are? Don't you ever hit your sister like that again. Don't you hit anyone like that again. And don't walk away when I'm talking to you. Not ever.
Bitch. Some more coffee.
What is it? I'll get the coffee.
Something wrong.
It's all right.
Now, there's got to be something wrong.
It's all right. It's all right. We'll try again.
Between March and April, just over 33,000 people joined the dole queues, pushing the total to 2,517,958. But compared with the closing months of 1980, when the monthly increase often averaged 100,000, it's clear the rate has slowed considerably. But that was still not much cheer for Jim Pryor, the Employment Secretary. Unemployment, he said, would continue to hit the country hard for some time yet. Other reactions from Mr. Pryor's Labour shadow, Eric Varley, an indelible stain on the government's record. From Len Murray, another dismal and depressing post-war record.
Said you were coming in.
Yes, but I've still got masses of work to do.
But you work all the time.
My thesis is due in 6 months.
Anyway, what difference does it make? You were asleep.
Turn the telly off and I'll come and work in the city.
Well, there's nothing to do.
And don't forget, tomorrow's Thursday. I'll be back about 10.
Stay out as long as you like.
Oh!
Sorry, I thought you were a burglar.
I didn't know you were here.
Well, I work late every Thursday. Do you need any help?
No. I meant to be drafting a proposal for my book, but Mavis has been on at me, you know, to sort this.
Well, she'll be pleased with the result.
Absolutely. Tell you the truth, I fancy a drink. Do you have time?
Well, I'm working on my thesis, but,
Well, we could talk about it over a drink, if you think it would help.
All right, yes. I'll get my stuff.
Okay. My idea is that an individual's social identity is created not really by other people, but by oneself. You see, through the conscious.
Have you had salad, sir?
No, thank you. No.
Sorry?
Through the conscious and unconscious management and presentation of self, you see. Most things we do as a matter of course, of habit. That's why I'm so interested in the first actions people perform on waking. What do you do?
Groan.
I know, but then what?
I take the book off the alarm clock, I turn off the alarm.
Yeah, which book?
Well, that changes.
Yeah, I know, but now, which book?
John Donne.
But Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper. The end. You were reading.
We were.
Lights out in 10 minutes.
Okay.
I mean it.
Yeah.
I mean it. Give you a lot of work?
Yeah.
Can I help?
Nope.
Sure?
Yes.
You know, when I was your age, I stopped talking to my parents for 4 whole years. For no reason at all. I hope it doesn't happen to us.
Dad, I have an exam tomorrow. Dad?
Yeah?
When's Mum coming home?
Soon. You're an unusual woman.
I ought to go, you know.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Is it possible?
Of course.
Thank you. No, I mean it. I'm not. I don't think I've ever met anyone like you.
No, well, you wouldn't, would you?
Why?
There isn't anyone quite like me.
You have all the power, really, don't you? Women. I don't mean silly power, like money or politics or any of that. Real power, do you know? Real power. Fundamental power.
So have you had lots of affairs, then?
No, I haven't had lots of affairs. Why do you ask?
Doesn't matter. Keep her from. Does your wife know?
Your wife's up. Thank you very much. Please see. Some people don't want to know the truth, even if they know it. I protect her by being discreet, that's all. I have to have affairs. To be involved, it makes me feel vital. I don't tell my wife because I love her. I don't want to hurt her. I don't want to leave her. And apart from anything else, the children would be upset. I'm wondering if she. I can't make myself turn my back on new experiences. Don't you agree?
You hurt by deceiving.
Well, I don't think so, and I don't quite know why you're going on about this. I mean, are you trying to prove something, like I'm a dreadful person?
Yes, of course. You're a dreadful person. You're a man. Doesn't mean I don't like you.
Are you hungry?
Fall in love, for one thing, and I really, really don't want to fall in love.
Yeah, but we will make love. You'll love me, and
I can't.
I understand, I know. There are women, special women like you, who can't go to bed with a man unless they love him.
And men like you.
So how are you? Is everything okay? I did well this evening with the book. Good work, I think, I hope. Oh, yeah, I think.
Would you like some more wine?
I must have a pee. I'd love supper.
Health and safety, on the arts, and so on. But the actual power wielded by the Greater London councillors is not that great. The London boroughs and their councillors...
I got through chapter 6 in my thesis.
Affairs, and the GLC is also severely restricted by the government. All capital expenditure has to be approved by Parliament, and the government imposes spending targets. And so, whoever wins the elections, there's a limit on how much radical change or reform they can actually put into practice.
Come to me like a child that lies this way. You make me laugh and make me cry with the words that you say. Will your love be around?